Okay, so July special inspiration. Got this piece of paper, it's a bit worse for wear, it's been crumpled and ripped, but it'll do fine for this. So first step is strips of newspaper or magazine. So just gonna tear this into strips. Stick it down. I think I have a plan for this. Where's that hole? There, I'll cover that. There we go. A little bit there, just because it looks a bit stark, so stick that there. There we go. And then the next step will be to put a wash of colour over the top. So I'm so I'll just give that a little bit of time to dry down and then we'll do that. Okay, so a wash of colour. Put this deep turquoise, might mix it also with some of this blue, this one's cerulean blue hue, and I'm just gonna grab some water, spray the page. I'm just gonna have to do that because I'm running out of water a bit. Tiny bit of that down. Come on. Tiny bit of this down. Oh, that's too much, I think. brush and get it all spread. Use my phone, that's a group chat for work. Everybody's having a good laugh today, I think. Okay. So, there's a little bit much paint, so, too much paint, I should say, not much paint. Words. Right, let's pop that to one side a sec. I'm going to move that way, I see it a minute ago. Chaos. Yes, everywhere. Well, this box here. Baby wipes. Okay. Love it. Now, where is the list? Here it is. So we've done some washcloth. Right, random stamping. Now, I need to find something to use. I don't think the text stamp is going to be any good because I've got text in the background and you won't be able to see it. So, I'll find something, perhaps just a simple shape or something, and I'll be back in a minute. Okay, so I think we're going to go for this checkerboard style stamp. What colour? Do I want to go for a darker blue, or black, or grey? Brown, purple, yeah, I'm just going to go for the blue. Let's go for prize ribbon. It's quite a distressy kind of stamp anyway, so I'm not going to worry about it. Perfect. I've just made a mark on my page. Okay. Good. Okay, so I've got a tiny bit of gesso, and I guess we're just gonna make some marks. There we go. And I keep putting the paper down. There it is. Colour through a stencil. Now, I've got this I'm going to use. I'm going to let this dry first. Yeah, I'll let that dry and then we'll add a little bit of colour through that. Okay. So I have my indigo blue sky pink. I'll use this little bit of sponge that I've got hanging around. Hoping that this will show. I think maybe we need a spot of gesso in with that. Similar place. That's about right. So I want this and this. Better. A little bit more in that corner. And perhaps a tiny bit there. Okay, I think that's plenty. And now we need focal point, or image, focal image, or images. So, I'm diving into my anti-corrupt sticker book, and I'm grabbing this. Lovely dancing couple. Them down here and then have our words at the top. Okie dokie, so I need to dry it a little bit more so I can write on it. So I'll be back in 1 minute. Okay, and I'm going to be brave. I'm just going to use this permanent marker. I'm just going to go straight onto it. I'm just going to... Oh, I spelt that wrong already. Never mind. No one will know. It's our secret, okay? Oh. grab this day. Okay. In his joy. There we go. And that is my poetry quote from Jabberwocky by Lewis Carroll. One of my favourite poets, because it's nonsense. Okay, so now I need to do a border. I think I'm going to stamp something, so I'm going to go find my stamps in one sec. Okay, so I'm going to use this one. I don't know what set this is from. I'm afraid it's an old set. But yeah, I'm going to use this one. I'm going to use the stamping platform so we can get it nice and straight and neat and make sure it stamps nicely. Let's use the actual stamp side and not the lid, shall we? And I'm going to use black to try and match my writing. Sorry about that music. That's coming in through the bathroom window. Someone outside. Nice, we want it a bit darker maybe. Load it, load it, load it. Yeah, okay. And then it's gonna go over the edge. Okay, so I'll fast forward through just doing this. You don't want to sit and watch me do all this, do you? Okay, so that's all the prompts done. I kind of went a bit wonky here, so I thought I'll just embrace it and do it everywhere else, so yeah. But I just feel like it's missing a little something, so I'm going to go around my stars, or most of them, if not all of them, to just add a bit more black and a bit more punch to the page. Everything's just a bit one dimensional, I suppose. Don't really want to add black splatters or anything. I noticed as well whilst I was doing the border, I remembered the page, the newspaper, was from when we went to Chester, so every now and then dotted around is the word Cheshire, which I thought was quite fitting. I've just put my hand in that gesso. Transfer it on the page too much. I'm so messy. A lot of it is when I'm doing this in a rush. I want to get this page finished today and edited. And also my tea journal pages that I'm doing simultaneously. So I get some more video of that for you guys. Also need to do today's advent calendar. Yeah, door. I'll do that first so it's out. Okay. And a little bit more here. Roughly, I'm not looking for perfection. I'm just, like I say, just trying to add a bit more black, a bit more pizzazz to the page. Okay. Where is my white? Do we try a few black splashes? I don't know, it's just something is not quite gelling. I'm not sure what it is. I want too much, just what is it? Come on, help me. My finger in anything wet. Okay, I think I'm going to just spend some time and go around these letters with some white. Cool. Okay, now my battery's flashing, so we'll date that and we'll call it done. Thank you for watching. I hope you join